Ghana has completed a new international airport named Tamale International Airport. And in this video, I'm gonna reveal the history and the details about this airport. So comment, like, and subscribe for more videos like this. Let's get started. Tamale International Airport is an airport serving Tamale, a town in the northern region of Ghana. During World War II, Tamale Airport was established as a major advanced operation station for troops. In December 1940, the landing strip at Nyohina, about 2 miles west of Tamale, was bought. Realizing its strategic importance, the government of Ghana's First Republic approved a plan to develop a new international airport to service the military 11 miles north of Tamale. Despite a promising start, the project was abandoned upon the regime's collapse in 1966. Work on the airport, however, resumed with some changes to accommodate civil operations. Initially, the airport was manned by the Air Force, but with the passage of time, aid from the GCAA was sought to provide personnel for telecommunications and to assume responsibility of the RFFS and other facilities. On August 2019, President Nana Akufo-Addo cut the sod to begin the second phase of Tamale Airport reconstruction. The project was funded by a UKEF facility with assistance from KfW-IPEC Bank and was planned to be finished in 30 months. The number of work included the construction of a modular airport terminal building of approximately 5,000 square meters that can be expanded in the future, a 1,000-meter square hatch facility, a single carriageway access road, land side and air side infrastructure adapted to the terminal size, and water, electricity and sewage infrastructure found necessary for normal operation. Tamale, the northern regional capital, was officially welcomed into a new era on Tuesday, 22nd August 2023 afternoon, when Vice President Dr. Mahamudu Bawumia launched the second phase development project at the Tamale International Airport in a brief ceremony. The airport, which now has international status as a result of the expansion project, has formally opened to international air travelers. This follows the Ghana Airport Company Limited successful project testing and simulation exercises. The $70 million expansion project included the construction of a new terminal building as well as other ancillary facilities such as a VIP lounge, 2 boarding gates, 4 self-service check-in kiosks, 8 check-in desks, airline offices, commercial retail areas, and a multi-purpose terminal for hatch travel facilitations and a 5-kilometer road network. The airport also contains a 350-car parking lot, a technical area with a reservoir for potable water and firefighting equipment, and a sewage treatment plant, among other amenities. The Vice President, Dr. Mahamudu Bawumia, inaugurated the facility on Tuesday, stating that the terminal was designed for 400,000 passengers per year, and that with the opening of the new terminal, a number of airlines will now fly directly from Tamale to various parts of the world. He stated that the project was in accordance with the government's attempt to expand airline infrastructure in order to encourage businesses in the country and attract foreign investors, as well as to make Ghana an aviation center in the West African sub-region. He went on to say that the Tamale International Airport will now be a good option and complement to the Kotoka International Airport for international travel, as well as a nav point for air travel from the north and Sahel to Europe and beyond. Agriculture is known as a major sector in the north, so this project would help boost agro-based agriculture. He explained, "It is a major hub for air cargo for the exportation of agricultural produce to Europe and various parts of the world. Apart from that, Dr. Bawumia stated that the annual Hajj pilgrimage had gotten a significant boost because the new terminal could now accommodate more aircraft for international travel. Kweku Ofori Esiama, Minister of the Transport, stated the new airport would help promote international trade, tourism and culture, while pushing existing local airlines to boost their frequencies in order to provide services to the traveling public at all times. He urged international airlines to consider expanding their services to the region. He reaffirmed the government's commitment to extending aviation infrastructure and services to all regions of the country. The aviation sector had seen significant development in infrastructure development and service expansion over the previous 6 years. In tandem with the implementation of the government's simplified sky policy, Shani Hassan Shaibu, the Northern Regional Minister, said the project indicated that the government cared about the people of the region and the entire northern section of the country. He urged investors to explore investigating the region's numerous investment potential in order to assist create jobs for the region's teeming young and open up the area. The Tamale International Airport is the third busiest airport in Ghana with 280,000 passengers in 2022. Thank you for watching. Comment where you are watching from. Like and subscribe for more videos like this. I will see you in my next video. Bye.